Hi, I'm Pooja Monga. I'm the founder of Saltpetre. Saltpetre means salt of the earth. We are an eco-minimal lifestyle brand that currently offers workwear for women. Primarily, the materials that we work with are a wood-based fiber, fiber that's extracted from the bark of woods, organic cotton, and we've recently experimented with fabric made out of recycled PET bottles. Everything we do at Saltpetre is addressed at maximizing the value for the customer while minimizing the impact on the earth. We keep the designs very minimal and unadorned of any trims which are not serving any functional purpose. So even if there are trims being used, they are biodegradable. What we offer currently is work-ready, minimal and comfortable silhouettes for women. I decided to collaborate with other fashion designers. One of them is Signe Rosenkrantz, she's Denmark-based. And the other is Yvette Vanderburg, who's South Africa-based. They would create sketches and designs as per the vision board that I create. After the designs are shortlisted, they would give me tech packs of those designs, all the specifications that can be taken to a garmenting unit. So this wood-based fiber essentially is extracted from wood. They are not general forests, but they are man-farmed forests, so which are farmed without pesticides or fertilizers. The wood is taken from these trees. Every tree cut is of course replenished because it's a business for these guys. So like just like wood-based fiber, there is a new innovation in fabric which is available at scale, which is made out of recycled PET bottles. So PET bottles that are collected from landfill are broken into shards, melted, and yarn is and fiber is drawn out of it to make fabric. As part of that whole circular design model, while we design for longevity of use of the product, what we also offer is at the end of its life, we take accountability for it. We offer a take back system. You just write a mail to us saying loop back in the subject line, and we'll pick it up from your doorstep to either reuse it, repurpose it, or to finally recycle it. So for instance, if it has to be repurposed, we would give it to an institution like Goonj, where it can be repurposed into either sanitary napkins or school bags or whatever else, depending on the material of the garment. So for our packaging, we don't use plastic either. We wrap our product in craft paper. What we do is we also send a packet of herb seeds with each of our products and an instruction guide on how this particular packaging can be used as a seed starter for those herb seeds that come with the product. So the packaging is deliberately kept of a higher GSM, and it can be torn into two parts where the lower part can be then used as a seed starter. So the instruction guide pretty much explains how you can sow your seeds, incubate them for 4 to 6 weeks, by which time the seeds should germinate into saplings and then you can transfer them elsewhere. The intention was to make lifestyle products accessible, as accessible an alternative to mainstream brands as they are. Why should a customer have to compromise by paying through his nose to buy something that is sustainable when it should be as easily accessible as any mainstream brand?